You already done killed my homie. I got to get one of yours now. I'm not saying it like I've done that, but that's just how it goes.
Before Schoolboy Q would drop his album Oxymoron and the hit single Man of the Year, before he was arrested at the South by Southwest Music Festival for being in possession of some weed, before he would become the fourth member of Black Hippie alongside Kendrick Lamar, J-Rock, and Absol, as a kid growing up in South Central LA, he earned for himself the moniker of Schoolboy because he was a little bit of a keener. He was always wearing his thick glasses, and he had a 3.3 grade average in high school. How'd he get it? Well, he would cheat in every class. He simply wasn't interested in school.
My hottest teacher in school was probably Miss Rickenbach, and I hated this bitch.
His priorities were sports. He played 4 years of high school varsity baseball and eventually some college football. During this time, he was living a double life. He was also a member of the 52 Hoover Crips, where he would sell drugs and prescription pills, and he also had his own addiction problems to deal with. Eventually, he got locked up, and following that, well, he decided to make a career for himself in music. My name is Michael Creden, documenting the life of Schoolboy Q prior to fame, here for you on Before They Were Famous. Now, a lot of you guys, you asked for this one like crazy, so I hope you enjoy it. Also, be sure to let me know in the comments down below who's next. Born Quincy Matthew Hanley on October 26, 1986 in Germany on a military base to a pair of military parents. Q spent the first 3 years of his life growing up in Texas before his family relocated to Los Angeles. Growing up on the corner of 51st Street and Figueroa, just 8 minutes from the Staples Center, he himself took an interest in sports extremely young and was playing football at the age of six. He also attended 52nd Street Elementary. Shortly after his family had moved to Los Angeles, well, his parents would split, and then he would start to rebel. You know, first he would skip class, then he decided to join a gang, and then he decided to sell some drugs, and then he was like a really bad dude.
Because I had moments where I was shaky at times, I don't know if I really want to do this type of shit, but then when it hits the fan, I turn to a whole different person, you know what I mean? Some people fold under pressure and some people don't.
Then we had lost faith in the education system, thinking like, Christopher Columbus? How's that going to help me? Instead, he would cheat through school his entire way through school, and he was pretty good at it. He got himself a 3.3 when he was attending Crenshaw High School. He didn't mess around when it came to sports. He was on the baseball team, the football team, as well as the basketball team. He was even on the swimming team. Can you imagine that?
Whose talent do I envy? Mine.
Now, his grades in his athletics and the fact that he wore some thick glasses earned him the nickname of Schoolboy from his after-hour gangbanger buddies. As for the Q, well, that comes from Quincy. His name. Another passion in his life was music, and he was a huge fan of East Coast rappers. Stating his favorites coming up were Nas, Jay-Z, Cam'ron, the Notorious B.I.G., and 50 Cent. He penned his first rap at the age of 16, but he never took it seriously until he was in his 20s. He went on to attend Glendale Community College, Los Angeles City College, Southwest College, and West Los Angeles College. The latter of which is where he would play football for the West Los Angeles Oilers. Simultaneously, he also brought in for himself a pretty lucrative income. He was a drug dealer, he would sell coke, he would sell crack, he would sell marijuana, but on top of that, he would sell prescription pills. Mainly Oxycontin, then he himself developed a taste for Xanax and Percocets. In 2007, at the age of 21, Schoolboy Q got arrested in a charge related to home burglary. He got 6 months, three of which he was able to serve at home on house arrest. That's when he took a hard look at his own life and decided it was time for him to focus on his music. As soon as he had made just a little bit of money doing that, well, then he was hooked. His first mixtape, the autobiography Schoolboy Turned Hustler, was dropped in 2008 and quickly caught the attention of Kendrick Lamar and Top Dog Entertainment. Lamar would form the Black Hippie Collective with Schoolboy along with J-Rock and Absol, while Top Dog would sign the artist to their label. His Gangster and Soul mixtape landed in 2009, and in 2010, Schoolboy Q welcomed his daughter, Joy Hanley, into the world, but not all was picture perfect. During this time, he was working as Kendrick Lamar's hype man, but when he was back home, he'd be back on the streets, he'd be back selling drugs. That's when Top Dog Entertainment sat him down. They told him he had to get his shit together. Also, he had to sort out his own addictions. Following this sit-down talk and a re-evaluation of his life, he released his debut, Setbacks, in 2011. And this album, well, it was about his life up to this point. And now that he had his head clear, he had his shit together, and his rhymes tight, well, he felt like he'd finally arrived. The follow-up, Habits and Contradictions, arrived the next year, and it moved to iTunes' Top 10 Albums chart. 2 years in the making, his third album would drop, this one titled Oxymoron, and this one was produced with some top-tier musicians, including the likes of Pharrell Williams, Mike Will Made It, and Tyler, the Creator, among others. And the rest of the story, well, you know the story because this is Before They're Famous. My name is Miles McCracken, and I decided to get all fancy for Schoolboy Q because I always have a little bit of a keener as well. Anyway, guys, be sure to let me know in the comments down below who you want me to document next. I've done a whole lot of rappers. I've done Kendrick Lamar, I've done Tyler, the Creator. I've done Eminem, I've done Riff Raff, I've done Logic, I have done Hobson. I don't know. Who's next? Let me know down below, and I'll see you guys in another video.
Walk with my shirt off, baby. Too sexy for you niggas and bitches, bitch.